Welcome to Spotlight Matthew 4. Today, in this devotional study, we continue to walk with Jesus through the final week of his life, often called Holy Week in many of our Christian traditions. And in our last devotional study, we saw that Jesus caused a ruckus at the temple when he cleared the temple out of the corruption that was occurring there, and therefore came into a direct confrontation with the religious leaders, the chief priests and leaders of the temple, and they could clearly see that Jesus was critiquing them and their way of handling the house of God. So with that in mind, Jesus then is departing from the city, and as he does so, we see Jesus doing something, an act, a supernatural act that is really unparalleled and unprecedented in his public ministry to date. What is that act? Well, we read of it today here now in chapter 21, verses 18 through 22. In the morning, as he was returning to the city, he became hungry, and seeing a fig tree by the wayside, he went to it and found nothing on it but for leaves. And he said to it, "May no fruit ever come from you again." And the fig tree withered at once. When his disciples saw it, they marveled, saying, "How did the fig tree wither at once?" And Jesus answered them, "Truly I say to you, if you have faith and do not doubt, you will not only do what has been done to this fig tree, but even if you say to this mountain, 'Be taken up and thrown into the sea,' it will happen. And whatever you ask in prayer, you will receive if you have faith." What is unusual about this particular supernatural act by Jesus? Well, we've seen many supernatural acts to this point, and they have been acts of healing people who are sick, ridding people of diseases. He touches and cures the blind and the maimed and the blind and those who have other infirmities. He casts out those who are demons from those who are oppressed or possessed by them. He even resurrects people from the dead. He calms the raging sea to bring safety and security to his disciples whom he loves and cares about. But here, Jesus enacts supernatural violence upon a fig tree, and it should stand out to us as uncharacteristic of the way in which Jesus normally uses his authority as the Son of Man. So why is Jesus doing this? Is this somehow, after confronting the Sadducees and the religious experts, Jesus is frustrated and behaving badly and taking it out on some poor fig tree? Well, of course, that is not the case, to be sure. Instead, what's going on here is that the fig tree, classically and historically, was an Old Testament image and an intertestamental image of the people of God, Israel. And what Jesus is indicating here through the symbolism of cursing this fig tree is that Israel itself is about to bring itself under a great curse. The time of judgment is soon to be falling upon these really religious people who are so mishandling the things of the temple, when indeed, as Jesus pointed out, they should be making the temple a place of prayer for all kinds of people. It should be pure in its worship of God. It should be a place for hearing the word taught and having people healed and their needs met. But this is not the focus. And Jesus says, yes, the time of judgment soon will fall upon the temple and upon its leadership and upon the nation, as symbolized by this cursing of the fig tree. And we know that indeed within a generation, this is precisely what happened in about 66 AD through some zealot activity. The Jewish people in Palestine began to rise up and rebel against the Roman occupation. Well, Rome was not going to have anything to do with tolerating that kind of nonsense from their perspective. And they sent in the Roman legions, and under Titus surrounded Jerusalem in April of AD 70. And by August, they had broken through the walls of Jerusalem and they took the temple of God apart, stone by blood-stained stone. According to Josephus, the Jewish historian, upwards of 100,000 Jews were captured and deported as slaves to different nations and different places. And according to Josephus, as many as a million Jews died by the edge of the sword during the fall of Jerusalem. Now, those numbers may be somewhat inflated, but nevertheless, not so much as to miss the point that cataclysmic judgment was at hand. And in the sense of Old Testament prophets, Jesus is doing an acted parable or an acted symbolization of what lies before them. And of course, they are about to, these really religious people, do the most heinous and worst of their acts. Jesus knows that it is but a few days until they will crucify him as the Lamb of God and the Son of God, and in doing so, bring and fill up the fullness of judgment upon themselves. So, then after that acted parable by Jesus on the fig tree, we then have something interesting occur. The disciples say to Jesus, how did this happen? And Jesus' response to them again is, truly I say to you, if you have faith and do not doubt, you'll not only do to this fig tree what has been done, but you'll say to this mountain, be moved, thrown into the sea, and it will happen. And of course, that mountain is Jerusalem itself. It was Mount Zion. It was the place of the temple. And this is probably figurative language by Jesus. He is not talking about his disciples actually levitating and hurling great mountains into the sea. After all, Jesus had no interest in them removing Mount Zion, and there wasn't a sea nearby for them to throw it into. So please understand and take this to be the figure of speech that Jesus intends. What Jesus, I think, is doing here is pointing towards the kind of church that he wants. There will be a replacement. There will be a new community. And what is to be the mark of the new community? The mark of the new community is that it is to be a people who walk by faith, who live by faith, who take action proactively by faith to do the things of God. It is to be a people who pray by faith and who, through their prayers and their actions, in effect, are moving spiritual mountains for the glory of God and to further the kingdom of God. Jesus is saying that he does not want his people to be like the fig tree and therefore like the Jewish leaders who are not producing fruit. No, he will be looking for a new community that produces great fruit for the glory of God. Because Jesus does say in the book of John, apart from me, you can do nothing, but when you walk in me, you will be those who bear much fruit, because that is the will, the pleasure of our Father. So I think there's a contrast here between the old community, its leadership that is passing away and coming under judgment, and Jesus' call to a new community, a community of faith. Are you part of the new community? Are you living by faith? Are you walking by faith? Are you trusting Jesus to be the one who moves the figurative mountains in your life and uses you to move the figurative mountains in this world so that God may be glorified and the kingdom may come and his will may be done on earth as it is in heaven? That's the call that Jesus is giving when he curses a fig tree during Holy Week, AD 30. And that's Spotlight Matthew. As always, check us out on spotlightgoodnews.com. Take advantage of our other resources. And please do like us on Facebook and share us with others and read the passage yourself. Meditate and ask the Lord to apply it to your life. And we'll talk to you next time.